In this video, you will understand how a hyperlapse video is processed by using a mobile phone and the images clicked by a DSLR. Hyperlapse is basically a motion time lapse. Let us understand how it works on the mobile phone first. Start by putting your phone in time lapse mode and frame your shot carefully, keeping note of the point of focus and keeping the frame stable by ninja walk as depicted. This is how we take hyperlapse shot on the mobile phone. Next is while using a DSLR. For this, we must put our cameras to manual mode, set the exposure to be balanced and switch to live preview. So we can use the grid lines to keep the frame fixed, and by keeping a point in focus, we move towards the focus point step by step. We must also keep in mind that if the steps are not as per the frame requires, the final result might not be as good as it might have been. Next comes the editing. Let's start by creating a folder containing all the pictures. We are using Adobe Premiere Pro 2019 for post-processing. You may use any available version. Here, we are creating a new project and giving it a title, say Hyperlapse Tutorial, and keeping the default settings. In the Location tab, insert the address where you want to save the project, click OK. The project screen will appear, which includes the timeline, media library, etc. Import your images by clicking File, Menu and Import, or just Ctrl+I. Select a photo from which you want to start the hyperlapse and make sure to check the image sequence box at the bottom and click Open. All individual images will merge into a single sequence. Drop the sequence in the timeline by dragging it. To stabilize the hyperlapse, we use Warp Stabilizer, which is in the Effects window under the Video Effects tab. To apply the effect, drag and paste it over the original video in the timeline. Go to Effects Control window to modify settings of the Warp Stabilizer. You can keep the default settings under Stabilization and Borders tab. After the effect is applied, the timeline changes its color. You can now export the project using Export in the File menu or by pressing Ctrl+M. To export it as an MP4 player, select H.264 in format and select the required preset or platform of viewing with the resolution required. You can select the source range as entire sequence, which wouldn't matter as we have only one sequence in the timeline. Rest everything can be default. You can change the file name or location in the output name section. Click export and the hyperlapse is ready to publish. Do not forget to save your project file for further references. Now here, you can watch a few examples and try it out yourself.